Hey everyone, Dominic Lehnert here, and by the end of this video you will know how you can get all the information you need out of espoCRM even if they don't send it to you by default. So for example, if you want to get notified every time a new lead is entered into your CRM system, then espoCRM is actually not going to tell you the email that this lead has, but there is a workaround for this and I will show you that right now. So let's get right into it. So over in Integromat, you can see when you try to build an integration with espoCRM that what we've set up here is a webhook. So every time we get a new lead into our espoCRM system, so someone in here selects create new lead, or we maybe automatically created a new lead from some other system. So we create a new lead here. Let's just do that. And then if we click save, now it created a new lead. And every time that happens, we want to know about it. And then maybe we want to fetch all the information from this lead. And then we want to add a new row to some master Google Sheet where we collect all the leads. And now if you're trying to do that, one thing you're going to notice if you're trying to actually map the input from espoCRM from the new lead you got, that you don't actually have all the information in here you need. So as you can see here in espoCRM, you have a ton of different fields, just very basic ones like email, and there's a lot more you can actually add here. And over here, if we now try to map the input, we will notice that there's actually not any email in here. So we can't even map the email. So okay, we have a name and a first name and a last name, but then if we try to map an email in here, we can't find it. And over here in an espoCRM, we see the email exists and we can even set it to be an email, but we still won't see it in Integromat. And the problem here, or not the problem, it's simply a fact that espoCRM doesn't send you all the information with the created a new lead webhook. So this webhook watches if a new lead was created, but it doesn't get all the information about this lead. But what we do get that we can see here is we get the lead ID. So this is the unique ID for each of the leads in our CRM system. And we can use this one to get all the information about the lead. So what we now need is we go to the lead section and then we select the module get a lead and we just drag this in the middle here. And we want to keep this connection and then we just have to hand it the lead ID. So we hand it the lead ID. And now what this will do is it will fetch all the information here. So every single piece of information you have on this lead will be fetched. Let's see if that really is the case. And then we can see over here. So just one quick tip. Now we have a lot of brown parameters here. And if we get confused which ones belong to which module, you can see if I hover over it, it's going to blink here on the left side. And if I hover over the other ones, the module is blinking the first one. So now, as you can see, we have a lot more input available. So we also have the email. Over here, for example, we can also have multiple email addresses actually. So now we can just use whatever information we need and we don't have the limited amount of information as in the just in the webhook. So this is how you can get all the information you need on your new leads out of your espoCRM system so that you can then build all the other automations that you want. So you can, for example, automatically send them a welcome email, thanks for reaching out or something like that. Or you can send them some specific PDF package. Maybe you have a freebie on your website or something you want to send them, or you want to forward them to someone so they can call them or they can email them or anything like that. I hope this was helpful. If you have any specific topics you would like a video on or a tutorial on, please feel free to just drop that in the comments. I will also link the Integromat cheat sheet below. So if you're just getting started with Integromat, this is really helpful to hit the ground running. And also if you're looking to get help with your automation scenarios and also just help in what makes sense for you to automate and how you would do that, feel free to reach out anytime. My name is Dominic Lehnert. Take care and goodbye.